our topic that we chose is Nursing Education by Lauren, Elizabeth, and Kelsey. Okay, the prerequisites that you have to have for a bachelor's in science of nursing. To start off your biology classes, you have to have our Bio 201 and 202, which is anatomy and physiology. It's a two-semester course that introduces the structure and function of the human body. Bio 201, that semester covers the cells and tissues of the body, skeleton, muscles, nervous system, and senses. Bio 202 focuses more on digestion, respiration, blood, cardiovascular system, lymphatics, immunity, reproduction, development, and endocrinology. Your math courses, Math 131 is college algebra. It emphasizes the study of functions and graphs, solving equations, inequalities. Math 231 is statistics. This course includes descriptive statistics, probability, and statistical inference with mean, standard deviation, variances, regression, and correlation analysis. Your psychology courses are general psychology and developmental psychology, lifespan, human growth and development. In general psychology, it emphasizes the system of psychology, brain and behavior, human development, consciousness, sensation, perception, learning, memory, and cognition. In lifespan and development, it examines cognitive, emotional, physical, and social development processes. Your English courses are English 101 and 102, which are your composition classes. It's a two-semester course that focuses on the standard written English, research, and analytical skills. You also have to have English 313, which is an advanced composition class. This course emphasizes exposition, argument, and research as a means of learning and communicating knowledge and ideas. There's some courses that you also have to have. MIS 210 and 220 are information management computer classes. This course introduces basic file management and internet functions, word processing, electronics, spreadsheet software, database management software, and presentation software. You also have to have Bio 261, which is microbiology. This course introduces the structure, function, and genetics of bacterial cells and bacterial diseases, as well as viruses and viral diseases in the human body. Okay, now Ashton's gonna talk to you about the courses you take when you're in the nursing program.
Okay, so we take Nursing 210, which is Introduction to Nursing. This course is designed to focus on the elderly, communication, safety, hygiene, mobility, and the comfort of the patients. It includes experiences such as practicing nursing in the community as a leader, advocate, and direct caregiver. Nursing 211, which is Fundamentals of Nursing. This course focuses on the beginning care of patients experiencing basic, acute, and chronic healthcare issues. Students will focus on providing patient-centered, holistic, culturally sensitive care to a variety of patients. Nursing 301, which is Pharmacology. This course explores basic pharmacology, including drug classifications, special considerations for the drug, administration, dosages and calculations of medications, and responsibility of a professional nurse in a patient-centered, safe and effective medication administration. Nursing 302, Health Assessment. This course focuses on the development and skills, developing skills and strategies needed to assess patients. At the end of this course, students are expected to be able to complete a head-to-toe assessment. Nursing 303, Pathophysiology 1 and 2. This course focuses on the study of pathophysiology associated with diseases and that are common throughout the patient's lifespan. Students will use critical thinking to relate system processes to factors and to risk factors in pathophysiology. Nursing 310, which is Mental Health Nursing. This course focuses on safe, effective, and culturally sensitive, patient-centered, evidence-based nursing care for patients with mental health problems while emphasizing therapeutic use of self-communication, information management, and professional accountability. nursing 312, 320, and 420, which is adult health nursing 1, 2, and 3. In this course, students will learn about patient experiencing comorbid conditions, which include alterations of the immunologic, hematologic, gastrointestinal, musculoskeletal, neurologic, renal, and reproductive functions. Nursing 400, family nursing. This course focuses on critical thinking and the nursing process and clinical decision making for well and high risk diverse patients that are starting families. Nursing 402, this course focuses on the history of nursing research and research methodologies. Nursing 403, issues and trends in professional nursing. This course explores current trends and issues in the nursing and the healthcare system. Topics include legal, political, economic, and accreditation forces that impact nursing and healthcare. Nursing 421, nursing leadership. This course focuses on leadership management theory and processes used to design, provide, and evaluate safe and effective patient-centered quality care in a variety of settings. Nursing 422, community health nursing. This course focuses on the development and application of knowledge underlying community health nurse practices, the use of critical thinking and creativity within the nursing process. Nursing 423, senior seminar. This course is intended to help the nursing student transition from student nurse to a registered nurse. Contents of this course help prepare students for the NCLEX exam. We also have skills and clinicals, skills labs and clinicals. Students are taught the proper way to perform skills in the healthcare setting, such as starting an IV, inserting a catheter, and administering medication. Instructors check off each student on their performance of each skill, which is then practiced in the clinical setting. So now Taylor's going to tell us about the NCLEX prep classes.
Okay, so there are many different ways that you can prepare for the NCLEX, but a couple of the website or programs are Brilliant Nurse was rated 5 stars. It's $75 a month. There's over 3,000 practice questions, and it is pass guaranteed. With the Brilliant Nurse, there is 24/7 support, and you can actually meet with your instructors through live streaming. The next one is Graduate X. It gives students a great study tool that will help them pass the nurse exams. It is a 4-star rating and is a little more expensive, but it's for a year and it's $289. There's over 4,500 questions, but there's no pass guarantee. And Kaplan, which is what we use at Martin, that it's a great program to help prep for your classes. There are 90 different standardized testing. It's available for RN and PN exams. It's a 4-star. It's $418 to $489 every 3 months. And there are over 3,000 questions, and it does also have a pass guarantee.